book of Psalms, chapter 20, verse 5. We will rejoice in thy salvation, and in the name of our God, Yahweh, the Heavenly Father. In the name of Yahweh Shai, we will set up our banners. The Lord fulfill all thy petitions. So the Heavenly Father, in the name of his only begotten Son, be the honor, glory, praise forever and ever. Who his word we call is Jehovah, whose real name in the Hebrew is Yahweh, and the name of his only begotten Son, whose real name in Hebrew is Yahweh Shai, who his word inwardly calls Yeshua, Jesus. Okay? Peace be upon the house of David, to the men, women, and children that shall be elect, the remnant of the Lord's chosen, okay? The descendants of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, the Israelites the Bible speaks of, and to the Israelite foreigners scattered throughout the whole world that don't know that they're Israelites. Peace be upon you. Through the Spirit, I want to get into this video, Lord willing, for the sheep, to bring some edification and also speaking blessings upon those that are in the faith, to let it be known, may the Heavenly Father, Yahweh, in the name of Yahweh Shai, bless your Feast of Simon. See, because as the scriptures speak about, we are to rehearse the righteous acts. Okay, though we're saved by grace, doesn't mean we're given a license to sin. Part of not sinning is keeping the high holy days. You know, we have holy days according to the scriptures. Unlike this world, they have Thanksgiving, Valentine's Day, Christmas. Okay, those things aren't of the Bible. They're not the holy days of the scriptures. We have days such as the Passover, okay, which when the scriptures speak about Easter, it's actually talking about the Passover. Like brothers bring out continuously, bunnies don't lay eggs, all right? We have the Day of Atonement, where we're supposed to afflict ourselves, meaning fast, no water, no food for a day. We also have Hanukkah, okay, a feast day, or a feast season, okay, a high holy day regarding feast. And we have another feast, just to speak about a few, or the season that we're in right now, brothers and sisters, is the Feast of Simon, okay? Which when you go into the Maccabees, you'll find out that that was a high holy day dedicated with our people, pardon me, celebrating from being able to be delivered from our enemies, which Lord willing we're going to go into. But first off, I want to read the scripture again, Psalms chapter 20, verse 5. We will rejoice in thy salvation, and in the name of our God we will set up our banners, the Lord fulfill all thy petitions. Yahweh, in the name of Yahweh Shai. Okay, we will rejoice in that salvation because we're looking for salvation. Even our forefathers, during the time of the Maccabees, during the time of the Egyptians, we looked to the Lord for salvation, meaning deliverance from our enemies, deliverance from our adversaries, deliverance from those that hate the Lord, these other nations. Because salvation isn't for all the other nations. And we have high holy days to celebrate and feast because the Lord delivered us from the other nations. And even high holy days feasts such as the Feast of Simon, where our forefathers fought against the other nations for our freedom. Okay, but now we have this spiritual, okay, fight. We have this truth, this wisdom, knowledge, and understanding, the gospel, the good news, which the Lord is going to come back to deliver his elect, Lord willing, was part of that. So reading on. Now know I that the Lord, Yahweh, okay, who in order to get to the Most High Yahweh, you have to come through his son, Yahweh Shai, the only begotten, the Messiah, the intercessor, the mediator, saved with his anointed, meaning his chosen, okay, he will hear him from his holy heaven with the saving strength of his right hand, his hand of righteousness. Some trust in chariots and some in horses, but we will remember the name of the Lord our God, Yahweh, and his son's name, Yahweh Shai. Because the scripture says, the elect shall call upon that holy name. Ecclesiasticus in the Apocrypha, chapter 17, verse 10. These other nations, this world, they like to trust in the sword, they like to trust in the gun, they like to trust in their army, but we will trust upon the Lord, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, whose real name, according to the Hebrew, is Yahweh, a so-called black man, dark-skinned man with white woolly hair, according to the Bible. Okay, that's the one that's going to bring us salvation. And he's going to do it by bringing his son with the chariots, which is what he calls UFOs, okay, the vehicles from heaven to deliver his elect. Lord willing, we're part of that. After this third world war, the war to end all wars, the war of Armageddon. You see, we're living in some beautiful times right now. If you pay attention to what's going on in the world, especially with what took place with America and Syria, War is right around the corner, and we have high holy days to remember how the Lord delivered us from the times of our wars. You see? So these are the things that we're supposed to be rejoicing in, brothers and sisters. Even though I'm feeling a little bit under the weather, the spirit is willing, but the flesh is weak. Hey, I'm happy as all can be, man. I'm happy as heaven, man. Because we living in the times where the Lord is going to deliver his people, Lord willing, we are the elect to see that deliverance, that salvation, just like how the Lord delivered our forefathers, alright? I'll read it again. Psalm chapter 20, verse 7. Some trust in chariots and some in horses, but we will remember the name of the Lord, our God, Yahweh, and his son's name, Yahweh Shai. They are brought down and fallen, but we are risen and stand upright. You see, that's what happened to all of our enemies, and that's what's going to happen to our enemies in these days that we live in today. The banking families, okay, these other nations, they're going to fall just like how Pharaoh fell, just like how the Egyptians fell, just like how the Medo-Persians fell, just like how the Assyrians fell, just like how the ancient Babylonians fell, just like how the Greeks fell, just like how the Romans fell, okay? You Rothschilds, you banking families, y'all going to fall along with the other nations, you leaders, okay, you presidents, all y'all going to fall and bow down to Yahweh and Yahweh Shad. They are brought down and fallen, but we are risen and stand upright. Save, Lord, Heavenly Father, Yahweh, in the name of Yahweh Shai. Let the King hear us when we call. The King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, who's also going to raise up King David, mighty King David, in the tabernacle of David, to get our people raised up to be able to fight in these times, man. Spiritually, man. There ain't going to be nothing that these other nations, there ain't going to be nothing that these banking families, there ain't nothing that the adversaries of our own people going to do to stop the judgment of the Lord, because it's coming swift and with power. Spiritual power, the same type of spiritual power that was given to our forefathers, and the same type of spiritual power that our Lord and Savior had, Yahweh Shah, who the world calls Jesus. Okay, so let's get it. This is the book of 1 Maccabees, chapter 13. Now, when Simon, okay, you find out in the book of Maccabees, we ain't gonna go through all of the book of Maccabees, it's a beautiful book in the Apocrypha. You got a King James 1611 edition Bible, you will have that there in it, okay. But just to focus specifically on the Feast of Simon, okay, dedicated onto one of the Maccabee brothers, okay, Simon, just to give you a quick backdrop, when our people were being persecuted by the Greeks, okay, Alexander the Creep, who they call this Alexander the Great, Great in Wickedness, okay, we had several men, certain specific chosen men that the Lord raised up with power to fight and rebel and to keep our nation whole. Okay, amongst these other nations trying to persecute us. So, I'm going to get into it. 1 Maccabees chapter 13, verse 1. Now, when Simon heard that Tryphon had gathered together a great host to invade the land of Judea and destroy it, and saw that the people was in great trembling and fear, he went up to Jerusalem and gathered the people together, and gave them exhortation, saying, ye yourselves know what great things I and my brethren and my father's house have done for the laws and the sanctuary, the battles also, and troubles which we have seen, by reason whereof all my brethren are slain for Israel's sake, and I am left alone. Now therefore be it far from me that I should spare my own life in any time of trouble, for I am no better than my brethren. Doubtless I will avenge my nation and the sanctuary and our wives and our children, for all the heathen are gathered to destroy us of very malice. Okay, keep in mind, the Maccabean brothers, they rebelled against some Greeks, they rebelled against some heathens, so-called white people, Edomites, that was trying to get our people to fall away from the laws and do abominations, such as eating pork, because pork is not a part of our dietary laws. It's actually an abominable food we're not supposed to eat, along with turning away from the Sabbath laws, just to bring you up to speed, the history, in order to get the mystery. Now, these brothers put their lives on the line for our nation, put their lives on the line for our people, for the women, for the children, and for the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, Yahweh. They put their lives on the line. And here it is, Simon, out of his brothers, was the last one left. And his life being put to the wall, being put to the test, he said, look, man, who am I that I should go out and hide when my brethren died for this nation, man? Died for our people. Hey, if I'm going to go out, I'm going to go out just like how my brothers went out, man. Go out swinging, go out fighting, go out for our nation, man. Go out for our God, man, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Verse 7. Now, as soon as the people heard these words, their spirit revived, okay? Because that's that manly vibe right there, man. That's that warrior vibe right there, okay? That's that mighty man vibe right there, okay? The scripture says the Lord is a man of war, Exodus 15 and 3. And with that type of spirit, that spirit of war, that spirit of valor, that spirit of honor, okay, that spirit of courage, that spirit of power, our people got revived at that time when they heard those words being spoken because the Lord was with Simon. That's why we hold this Feast of Simon, commemorating what took place in the ancient world. So reading on, verse 8. And they answered with a loud voice, saying, Thou shalt be our leader instead of Judas and Jonathan thy brother, because they went into the spirit world because they put their lives on the line and were there no more. Verse 9. Fight thou our battles, and whatsoever thou commanded us, that will we do, because they was ready to fight, because Simon was ready to fight, because our Heavenly Father put the Spirit on Simon to fight and be a leader for our people. Okay? So then, he gathered together all the men of war, and made haste to finish the walls of Jerusalem, and he fortified it round about. Also he sent Jonathan the son of Absalom, and with him a great power to Joppa, who casting out them that were therein remained there in it. So Tryphon removed from Ptolemais with a great power to invade the land of Judea, and Jonathan was with him in war. Now Tryphon, he was a heathen that was also over there, okay, with the Greeks, looking to have our people be slaves, man, looking to have our people get exterminated, you see? And still, with that man and his wickedness, okay, and all that he had set up to try to take our people's existence away, Simon and the choice men, the men of war that the Lord has set up and sanctified to be able to defend our nation, was like, nah, they ain't having that, man. Because our forefathers, during the time of Egypt, wasn't having it, man. Moses wasn't having it. Joshua wasn't having it. Caleb wasn't having it. Aharon wasn't having it, man. You see? So through the Spirit, hey, you can't forget about King David and his mighty men, man. They wasn't having it. And the scriptures speak about how the Lord's going to raise up the tabernacle of David as in the days of old. So reading on. Verse 12 of 1 Maccabees, the 13th chapter. So Tryphon removed from Ptolemais with a great power to invade the land of Judea, and Jonathan was with him in war. But Simon pitched his tent in Adida over against the plain. Now when Tryphon knew that Simon was risen up instead of his brother Jonathan, and meant to join battle with him, he sent messengers unto him, saying, Whereas we have Jonathan thy brother in hold, it is for money that he is owing onto the king's treasure concerning the business that was committed onto him. Now, once again, you do some reading on your own, brothers and sisters, you'll find out that Jonathan, okay, Simon's brother, he was captured by Tryphon, by them dirty heathens, man. Okay, so he put the word out, Tryphon, to Simon, look, if you want your brother, before you even try to do this war, you better be mindful that this person, okay, your brother, he's basically being held off of some bullshit pretense saying that he owes the king's treasury, which was a damn lie. Okay? Verse 16. Wherefore, now send 100 talents of silver and 2 of his sons for hostages, that when he is at liberty, he may not revolt from us, and we will let him go. Hereupon, Simon, albeit he perceived that they spake deceitfully unto him, yet sent he the money and the children, lest peradventure he should procure to himself great hatred of the people, who might have said, because I have sent him not the money and the children, therefore is Jonathan dead. So you see, Simon already knew what time it was, man. He had an idea that this heathen is lying out of his culo, okay? He's lying to try to get Simon to come through, okay, to lower his defenses, to be taken by coming with money and to come with Jonathan's 2 sons, so that when they made the exchange that Jonathan wouldn't fight. But you know what, out of being mindful and using wisdom for the people, he did what that damn heathen asked, because had he not did that, the people would have flipped out and been like, yo, if Jonathan would have lost his life, they would have blamed Simon for not bringing over the talents and following the orders, man. You see, so he had to use wisdom, because he wasn't just moving with himself in mind, but he was moving with the people's future in mind, you see? So reading on, verse 19. So he sent them the children and 100 talents, howbeit Tryphon dissembled, neither would he let Jonathan go. So you see, here it is. This heathen made a request, made a demand. Simon followed the demand, and he still wouldn't abide by his oath. You see, because that's the spirit of these heathens, man, especially the spirit of the wicked, the Edomites, the children of Esau, so-called Caucasians, okay, according to the Bible, man. Their tongue is like a fork, man. And we ask the so-called native Seminole Mexican Indians about how Esau gets down. The so-called Caucasians, conquistadors, Spaniards get down, man. They speak peace, but then they do something completely different, man. Because even though they speak peace, like the Book of Psalms says, war is in their heart. So read it on. And after this came, Tryphon to invade the land and destroy it, going round about by the way that leadeth unto Adora. But Simon and his host marched against him in every place, wheresoever he went. Verse 21, now they that were in the tower sent messengers unto Tryphon, to the end that he should hasten his coming unto them by the wilderness, and send them victuals. Wherefore Tryphon made ready all his horsemen to come that night, but there fell a very great snow, by reason whereof he came not. So he departed and came into the country of Galaad. And when he came near to Bascama, he slew Jonathan, who was buried there. Okay, you see? So Tryphon, he made a request, tried to make it seem like he was about peace. But even though Simon followed what Tryphon said, he still slew Jonathan, man. He still killed him. He still murdered him. Damn devil. Verse 24, afterward, Tryphon returned and went into his own land. Then sent Simon and took the bones of Jonathan his brother and buried them in Modin, the city of his fathers. And all of Israel made great lamentation for him and bewailed him many days. Verse 27, Simon also built a monument upon the sepulchre of his father and his brethren, and raised it aloft to the site with hewn stone behind and before. You see, so here it is, even though using wisdom, Simon wanted to do what was best for the people so that everything will work in accordance. But dealing with heathens, man, even if they put an agreement to you, they still won't follow the agreement, especially Esau, man, the children of the wicked. So the people mourned the death of Jonathan, and Simon went through the proper burial arrangements, okay, as far as having his bones retrieved to be buried in the place of his forefathers, man. Verse 28, moreover, he set up 7 pyramids, one against another, for his father and his mother and his 4 brethren. And in these he made cunning devices, about the which he set great pillars, and upon the pillars he made all their armor for a perpetual memory, and by the armor ships carved, that they might be seen of all that sail on the sea. This is the sepulchre which he made at Modin, and it standeth yet unto this day. Now Tryphon dealt deceitfully with the young king Antiochus, and slew him. And he reigned in his stead, and crowned himself king of Asia, and brought a great calamity upon the land. Now if you know something about Tryphon, right quick, he was supposed to be looking after Antiochus, because he was young, and he was supposed to be the one that was going to reign after the previous king. You see? But Tryphon had his own agenda, man. He slew Antiochus, or Antiochus, however you want to pronounce it, to reign in his spot. So this man was all the way with the wickedness. You see? So verse 33. Then Simon built up the strongholds in Judea, and fenced them about with high towers, and great walls, and gates, and bars, and laid up victuals thereon. Moreover, Simon chose men, and sent the king Demetrius, to the end he should give the land an immunity, because all that Tryphon did was to spoil. Unto whom King Demetrius answered and wrote after this manner: King Demetrius, unto Simon, the high priest, and friend of kings, as also unto the elders and nation of the Jews, sendeth greeting. The golden crown and the scarlet robe, which he yet sent on to us, we have received, and we are ready to make a steadfast peace with you, yea, and to write on to our officers to confirm the immunities which we have granted. You see, diplomatic, man. Our forefathers knew how to be diplomatic in those times when dealing with the other nations and knowing how to get down when we had a common enemy. But just to speak on, just going on right back into the scriptures, just to let you know what time it is, verse 38. And whatsoever covenants we have made with you shall stand, and the strongholds which ye have builded shall be your own. As for any oversight or fault committed unto this day, we forgive it, and the crown tax also, which ye owe us, and if there were any other tribute paid in Jerusalem, it shall no more be paid. And look who you Look who are meet among you to be in our court. Let them be enrolled, and let there be peace betwixt us. Thus the yoke of the heathen was taken away from Israel in the 117th year. Okay? See, looking at it in the sense, Tryphon or Antiochus, they would try to deal amongst themselves as far as the heathens with Ptolemy and King Demetrius as far as how they go and deal with Yasha Allah, but we was always a problem, so they would always try to get him on good side. And here's just an example of the Lord happening to where Demetrius actually saw fit to hold up his oath with Simon, who was also not just a warrior, but he was also considered as the high priest for our nation once his brothers were slain. So reading on, verse 42. Then the people of Israel began to write in their instruments and contracts in the first year of Simon the high priest, the governor and leader of the Jews. In those days Simon camped against Gaza and besieged it round about. He made also an engine of war and set it by the city and battered a certain tower and took it. And they that were in the engine leaped into the city, whereupon there was a great uproar in the city. You see, they did that warrior thing, man. It wasn't time to talk in that time. They got everything in order, made sure those that was playing like they was our allies, and it was time to go to war. And that's what Simon and his mighty men of war did. Verse 45, but so much as the people of the city rent their clothes and climbed upon the walls with their wives and children and cried with a loud voice, beseeching Simon to grant them peace, begging for mercy. That's how bad our forefathers put it on these other nations, men. Verse 46, and they said, deal not with us according to our wickedness, but according to thy mercy. So they begged for their freaking lives. So Simon was appeased toward them, and fought no more against them, but put them out of the city, and cleansed the houses wherein the idols were, and so entered into it with songs and thanksgiving. Meaning he destroyed them idols, man. He destroyed all those idolatry statues, all those pagan worships out of the holy temples. Got everything in order. Once he had to put the body game down, man. Because a lot of these people understand, you can't just speak peace, peace, and go marching. Our forefathers didn't just ask for peace, ask for deliverance, okay? Yeah, Moses asked Pharaoh, let my people go, but at the end of it all, the Lord hardened his heart. Why? Because in order to get the message across, there had to be plagues, there had to be bloodshed, there had to be war, because the Lord is a man of war. So that's how we got our freedom, reading on. Yeah, he put all uncleanness out of it and placed such men that, well, you know what, let's rewind to verse 47 again just so you can get the point. So Simon was appeased towards them and fought no more against them, meaning, okay, in order for there to be peace, he had to fight. So he fought no more after he established that peace, and the people begged for mercy, begged for their lives. But put them out of the city, meaning even though everything was cool, everything was gravy, he spared their lives, he still put them out of the city, meaning separated them from amongst us, because we're a holy people, okay, a chosen people, a special people above all nations. And cleansed the houses wherein the idols were, and so entered into it with songs and thanksgiving, man. Meaning that ass whooping, man, that judgment, that war was so mighty, and we laid it down so nice and right and tight that we break out into parties, man. We feasted, sang songs, and ate, man. Party, man. That's what it was. Verse 48, yeah, he put all uncleanness out of it and placed such men there as would keep the law. You see, because that shows you how strong and how the Most High cares and so serious about his law, established commandments, man. They're perfect. So after the warriors did their thing, it was time for the people to be set up there as leaders, as overseers, to make sure that the law was being kept and made it stronger than it was before, reading on. And built therein a dwelling place for himself. You see, he dwelt amongst the people. In the midst of, after everything was laid down, he didn't just scurry off. He dwelt there amongst the people, making sure everything ran nice, right, and tight. They also of the tower in Jerusalem were kept so straight that they could neither come forth, nor go into the country, nor buy, nor sell. Wherefore, they were in great distress for want of victuals, and a great number of them perished through famine. Then cried they to Simon, beseeching him to be at one with them, which thing he granted them. And when he had put them out of from thence, he cleansed the tower from pollutions. You see? So to those that try to put up a little resistance, they felt it, man, and still had to beg for mercy. And entered into it the 23rd day of the second month in the 170th year. with thanksgiving and branches of palm trees, with harps and cymbals and with vials and hymns and songs, because there was destroyed a great enemy out of Israel, men. So we remembered it, because here it is, our existence was almost wiped from off the face of the earth, but our people, they fought back, man. The Lord put that spirit in Simon to be manful, okay, to be a man of war, to get it in and defend our nation, man, along with the men of war that was with him, you see. He ordained also that the day should be kept every year with gladness, man, with peace, with gladness, with joy. This is the times that we live in, brothers and sisters. You're supposed to be joyful in these moments, man. Don't keep your heads down. Don't be in that woe is me spirit, man. The Lord has high holy days risen up for us to feel good about ourselves, man. We got a rich heritage. We got a rich history. We got a rich inheritance. We're the Israelites, man. The princes of the power and our women are the princesses and daughters of Zion. You see? This is something that we got to keep in mind, because the Lord is about to bring us back to that heavenly rulership, man, with our King of Kings, Lord of Lords, Yahweh Shai, the Anointed, to come and deliver us, Lord willing, we have the elect, you see. Moreover, the hill of the temple that was by the tower he made stronger than it was, and there he dwelt himself with his company, you see. Verse 53, and when Simon saw that John his son was a valiant man, he made him captain of all the host, and he dwelt in Gezerah, you see. Everybody got it in. Not just the older ones, not just Simon, okay, but even his son got it in, and his son was valiant, his son was a man of honor, his son was a man of valor, got it in with the war, and was made a captain of the host, and dwelt in Gezerah, you see, got himself a name in the midst of all of that fighting. So, just to give that in mind to brothers and sisters, to make you aware of the times that we're living in, hoping that Yahweh, in the name of Yahweh Shah, blesses y'all. Okay, you brothers and sisters that may be aware of the Feast of Simon that went in. Okay, once again, from verse 51, it says, and entered into it the 23rd day of the second month, okay? Pardon me, of the 171st year. 23rd, which basically means the 23rd day of the second month. Now, just to make you brothers and sisters aware, do the spirit of Yahweh, the Heavenly Father, Lord Father God, Yahweh, in the name of His only begotten Son, Yahweh Shah, brothers over here, the church, okay, the congregation, okay, through the spirit of Yahweh, Bashinah Shah, the Lord Father God has put the spirit on brothers, myself, and those like-minded with me to put our videos on one of the channels, Men of Valor 12. Okay, this is the home channel, if you've seen, okay, on YouTube. You can go in the About section to find out about the High Holy Day calendar that Yahweh Bashinah Shah, Yahweh in the name of Yahweh Shah, the Anointed, has blessed us to be able to come up with, okay, as a congregation, as a church, as a camp, so to speak. Okay, as you see here in the description, it says Saints of New Jersey, 12 Tribes of Israel. High Holy Days calendar, days are held from evening to evening. The new moons from 2017 to 2018, and also, okay, the High Holy Days along with the new moons. Okay, because the High Holy Day calendar, the righteous calendar, okay, is dictated by the moon. Okay, it isn't dictated by what the society says as far as January, February, March, okay, as far as so-called 12 months in the year, the way that the society paints it, with January being the first month and December the 12th month, when the word December comes from the word deci, meaning 10. Okay, but yet in this society it's the 12th month. Or everything is all backwards, man. And those different months is named after all these different idols and pagan gods and different people. You see, it's not named after how the biblical times was. But just to make y'all brothers and sisters aware of it, just right here, right quick, the first high holy day we got here is the Passover, which you look into the book of Exodus, the 12th chapter, it lets you know that the first month, the 14th day, you're supposed to have the Passover, just like our forefathers had it. Now here, the brothers did the first month, okay, because the new moon, the moon is decided by the new month, or pardon me, the month is decided by the new moon. Slip of the tongue. You can read about that in Ecclesiasticus in the Apocrypha, the book of Sirach, chapter 43, and also find out about how the Lord uses the sun and the moon and the stars, okay, especially the moon, to dictate when feast days come in and when different dates come in. as far as the book of Genesis, the first chapter and the 14th verse. So the new moon that Brothers Through the Spirit of Yahweh, in the name of Yahweh Shai, used for the first moon of the month, okay, came in February 25th to 26th. And 14 days after that is where we got March, okay, 11th to 12th for the Passover. So, but when the scripture says, okay, the 20th day, the 3 and 20th day of the second month, okay, what we have here is the second month, or the second new moon, but 3 and 20 days, or 23rd day from that, which, go right here, right quick, let's go to March 27th, okay, March 27th, alright, 27, 28, that's when the new moon came in. So let's just do 7 days simultaneous. 7, okay, the 3rd of April. Another 7 make a 14th, the 10th of April. Okay, another 7 will make it the 17th, the 21st of April. Okay, 21st, 22nd, 23rd. Okay, the 23rd at evening, the 19th, which we have today, April 19th. And keep in mind, we got some brothers and sisters that have a different High Holy Day calendar, alright, through the Spirit. Some of those in different congregations, Lord knows your heart and sincerity and truth. Yeah, new moon may have either came in on the 27th of March or the 28th of March. You see, depending on which resource you use to dictate when the new moon was visible in the heavens, in the sky. But as far as how the Lord Yahweh, in the name of Yahweh Shai, has brothers and sisters in this congregation used with this high holy day, this is the date that we have. Alright, the Spirit and the truth. So through the Spirit, that's where, right here, Feast of Simon, which once again, 1 Maccabees, the 13th chapter, specifically the 54th, the 51st verse to the 53rd verse, we can find out about the Feast of Simon. Okay? Little correction right there, Simeon, but Simon is what it is. Alright, April 19th to 20th. So, going back into it, right here. This is something that brothers and sisters want to keep in mind, because this is something that we use to celebrate, rejoice amongst each other about the days that was of the times of old. Whatsoever was written aforetime was written for our learning. Because our people rebelled and fought against the heathens that try to bring us down and try to erase us off the face of the earth. And that's exactly what we're going to do in these days. But the thing about it is, we're going to do it spiritually, not physically, not upon our own will, not with swords, guns, knives, bats, anything like that. Okay, like this government or this news wants to paint us up as so-called, like, you know, big bro, Gabar Rakab, through the Spirit of Yahweh Shai, would always bring out. Okay, they're trying to call us black Hebrew Israelites. Okay, no one's black. Okay, no one's black. Okay, no one's white. Okay, black means negative. Okay, white means pure. We're the real pure people. Okay, the Israelites, the sons of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, those of Latino, Hispanic, Native, Seminole, Indian, Mexican, Negro, West Indian, Haitian descent. Those that are scattered throughout the four winds of the earth, throughout the different parts of the world, from Negro, Latino, Native American descent on their father's lineage, you're the real pure people, okay? And these heathens, these Rothschilds, these banking families, so-called white people, they're the real negative, they're the real black people, they're the real, okay, wicked people, the children of the wicked. But as far as the scriptures are concerned, okay, this is a spiritual war that we're going through, okay? This is the book of 2 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 3. For though we walk in the flesh, we do not war after the flesh. For the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but mighty through the Most High God, Lord Father God, Yahweh, in the name of Yahweh Shai, to the pulling down of strongholds, casting down imaginations, and every high thing that exalteth itself against the knowledge of God. Okay? And bringeth it into captivity every thought to the obedience of who this word enemy calls Christ, which the word Christ means anointed, who the real name of the anointed is Yahweh Shai, the deliverer. Okay? There's power in this word, there's power in the gospel. Okay? This is the truth. The true good news. We're not going to be slaves in this society for much longer. We're not going to be underneath these other heathens for much longer. Wickedness is not going to be ruling in the society for much longer. There's going to be a judgment, and the Lord is going to bring deliverance, mercy, and grace to his chosen that repent and turn back sorrowful. But judgment, okay, pain, sorrow, slavery for those that decide not to take heed onto his word. Okay, and what I mean by slavery, I mean by you other nations going into slavery for everything that y'all did unto our forefathers. But those of our people that end up going into slavery or captivity, or end up taking that mark of the beast, the RFID chip, okay, the Bible speaks of, they're going to be slaves to the wicked. They're going to be slaves to these other nations, because they look at these other nations as God, that false idol, that white Christ, okay, because the Lord is a dark-skinned man with white woolly hair. Since they want to praise these other nations, since they want to worship Easter, since they want to worship Thanksgiving, they're going to be slaves to Satan, and they're going to end up being sacrificed in these last days. But in the kingdom of heaven, they're going to come back in their right mind once they're reborn through the elect. You see, the war that we fight right now is a spiritual war. It's not a carnal war. It's not a physical war with guns and knives and bats and missiles, okay, per se. It's a war spiritually fought by the word of the Lord, by faith, okay, by wisdom, knowledge, and understanding, by spiritual power from our Heavenly Father, Yahweh, in the name of His only begotten Son, Yahweh Shai. You see? This is the book of Zephaniah, chapter 3, verse 8. Because what these other nations, especially Esau, wants us to do is pick up guns and try to get on some revolutionary panther type, okay, movement. They want us to rebel with guns and fight with military might, okay, jump the gun, so to speak, but we're not commanded to do so. You see, this is the book of Zephaniah, chapter 3, verse 8. Therefore, wait ye upon me, saith the Lord, Yahweh, in the name of his only begotten Son, Yahweh Shai, until the day that I rise up to the prey, because the Lord is the one that's bringing this judgment. For my determination is to gather the nations, that I may assemble the kingdoms, and to pour upon them my nation. Even all my fierce anger, for all the earth shall be devoured with the fire of my jealousy. And that's exactly what the Lord is doing right now with the Third World War. You see, the war to end all wars in the land of Jehoshaphat, in the Hebrew, Yahweh Shaphat, the land of the Most High's judgment over there in the Middle East. Okay, the war of Armageddon, Harmagod won. The Lord is bringing over the mountain of troops for this Third World War, this nuclear war, where he's going to pour out the fire, that nuclear fire, upon all these nations, men, that fought against the Lord, especially America, Babylon the Great, which is going to go out like Sodom and Gomorrah, by nuclear fire to turn into a damn desert. You see, we're commanded by the Heavenly Father to wait upon him. We're commanded by Yahweh Shai to wait upon him, because that's where we're going to get that power. That's where we're going to get that redemption. That's where we're going to get that rejuvenation to be able to withstand in these times. This is the book of St. John, chapter 14, verse 12. Verily, verily, I say unto you, he that believeth on me, the works that I do, he shall do also, and greater works than these shall he do, because I go unto my Father. So just like how the Lord has spiritual power, was healing the sick, was feeding the multitude, was raising the dead, even in the book of St. John, pushed back the freaking heathens that was coming to yap him up. When they asked straight up, he told them, who you looking for? They said, Yahweh Shah of Nazareth. He said, I am he. And they fell backwards because he pushed them back with spiritual power. The Lord said, the works that he did, we shall do in greater. He even turned water into wine, man. You see, walked on water. Commanded the waters to calm down. He exorcised demons out of people, man. He gave sight to the blind, gave the lame the ability to walk, raised the dead. We're going to get that power and then some. You see, the works that he did, we shall do in greater than these. Because he goes on to the Father. When he was crucified, suffered, and after the third day was risen up into perfection, man, rose from the dead. Our Lord and Savior, our big brother, the Messiah, Yahweh Shai, the anointed, man. And whatsoever ye ask in my name, that will I do, that the Father, Yahweh, may be glorified in the Son. You see, we got to pray, but when we pray, we got to pray to the Heavenly Father in the name of the Son, Yahweh Shai, the anointed. You see, you got to have faith in that thing there too, man. You got to pray believing, just like how our forefathers prayed, man. Just like how our forefathers trusted in the Lord. Just like how our forefathers put their strength and trust and confidence in the name of Yahweh, okay? And so much so in the name of Yahweh Shai, because he brought us back on to the Father, you see? If ye shall ask anything in my name, I will do it. And best believe, brothers, Okay, those that sin, their right mind through the grace and mercy of Yahweh in the name of Yahushua are praying for deliverance, praying for mercy, praying for peace, praying for repentance, okay, and also praying for that spiritual power, man. Also praying for that spiritual power, just like our forefathers had it, you see? Praying in faith. Faith is a grain of a mustard seed. If we pray and wait and do the things that please the Lord, He's going to do what we ask of Him, man. Just have faith in that thing there. You see? If you love me, keep my commandments. And one of the commandments that was given, straight up, the two greatest commandments, love the Lord with all your mind, body, soul, heart, spirit. Okay? Follow His commandments to the best of your ability. And also, the second one that is likened on to the first one, love your neighbor as yourself, do unto others as you want them to do unto you. The golden rule. You see, you got to be brotherly in this thing because it's a body. It's not just one person, okay? It's not just about, okay, just the people that can speak or just the people that can, okay, make themselves seen in the eyes of the people. Nah, it's about your brothers, man. It's about your brothers and it's about the little ones too, okay? It's about our nation, the elect of our nation. The elect of our nation being risen up, okay? Even to the elect men, the elect women, the elect children, okay? The elect orphans, okay? The elect that's destitute, that's going through it. The elect that's homeless. The elect that's afflicted in their bodies. The elect that may be blind. The elect that may not be able to walk, okay? The elect that may be sick. The elect that may be elderly, man. You see, the Lord is going to raise up His elect with spiritual power. Lord willing, we're part of that to be able to heal those people, man. And fight against our enemies in that time. You see? Keep in mind, the scripture in Zephaniah 3 and 8 says, wait ye upon the Lord. Well, this is what the scripture in Isaiah chapter 40, okay, says regarding spiritual power to those that believe. Verse 28, Isaiah chapter 40. Hast thou not known? Hast thou not heard? That the everlasting God, the Lord, Heavenly Father, the Creator, Yahweh, of the ends of the earth, fainteth not, neither is weary. There is no searching of His understanding. So you ain't know? You ain't heard? With the Heavenly Father is strength and glory and might. You can't find out His understanding if He don't bless you to be able to understand Him, man. And He giveth His understanding. He revealeth His secrets to His servants, the prophets. Verse 29, He giveth power to the faint. And to them that have no might, He increaseth strength. Even the youth shall faint and be weary, and the young men shall utterly fall. But they that wait upon the Lord, Yahweh, in the name of His only begotten Son, Yahushua, shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary, and they shall walk and not faint. You see? Meaning mount up with eagle wings, meaning fly. Run and not be weary, meaning be like the flash, man. Walk and not faint, meaning we ain't gonna be stopped. When we get that spiritual power, Lord willing, soon, brothers, sisters, soon, the tabernacle of the Lord's, okay, house, meaning the men, the elect men, the house of David, King David and his mighty men, the elect, okay, those that follow the Lord in the regeneration, those that have an ear to hear, let him hear. The Lord is going to bless His elect, Lord willing, we're part of that, to have spiritual power, you see, and we're going to need spiritual power in these last days. You see, because it's not just that we need it through our forefather Jacob, whose name was changed to Israel. Yahshua Allah, meaning Prince of the Power, he got that after wrestling an angel. Because with us is with great power, you see. Isaiah chapter 59, verse 19. So shall they fear the name of the Lord, Yahweh, and His Son, Yahushua, from the west, and His glory from the rising of the sun. When the enemy shall come in like a flood, the spirit of the Lord, Yahweh, Bahashim Yahushua, in the name of Yahushua, shall lift up a standard against them. You see, so when these martial law troopers, when these storm troopers, when these mercenaries, when the militarized police try to run down on the Lord's chosen people, because that's what's going to take place during martial law, warlike law, when they're going to collapse the economy, collapse the Constitution, collapse the amendments, collapse people's rights, and just straight lock down society, because they're going to cause the chaos with pestilence, with collapse in the economy, okay, with disease warfare, causing these race wars, causing these class wars, to bring forth martial law, order through chaos, order ad chaos, so-called new world order, nouveau ordre seculaire, new order of the ages, nouveau ordre mundi, new world order, okay, when they come through with that martial law, with that RFID chip, the mark of the beast, the Bible speaks of, nowhere are we supposed to take that thing, man. Hold faith, even if you gotta put your life on the line to die, okay? You shall be risen up with great power, man. A crown of life over your head, and the dead in your house shall rise first. But to those that the Lord blesses with that grace and mercy, to be given that power, the scripture says, the Lord's gonna lift up that standard against them, okay? We're gonna fear the name of the Lord. We fear the name of the Heavenly Father, Yahweh, and the Son's name, Yahweh Shad. In the Western Hemisphere, where the truth is predominantly being spoken, man. The Western Hemisphere being America, aka Babylon. That's where the truth came from, okay? Which brothers have received from who we learned from, the apostles, elders of great millstone, who they learned from their elders, okay? Through the spirit of Yahweh and the name of Yahweh Shad. From the days of One West, man. People such as Elder Bivens, people such as Elder Masha, okay? People such as Elder Yaquab, okay? People such as Elder Ariyah, through the spirit of Yahweh and the name of Yahweh Shad. These are the ordinances or the foundations of how the truth was brought about in these last days, man. Through the spirit and power of Yahweh and the name of Yahweh Shad, to how brothers have to these very last days. And it may not just very well be brothers in a specific congregation as far as the Great Millstone Camp, the GMS Camp, who through the spirit of Yahweh, the name of Yahweh Shad, those brothers are being an example of pushing out diligence, okay, pushing out doing the work, instant in season and out of season. But you got brothers outside of the congregation speaking the same doctrine, Yahweh and Yahweh Shad's salvation, of deliverance, of the gospel of the kingdom of heaven is at hand, okay, throughout the four corners of the world, throughout the four winds of the world, okay? And even the elect amongst these other congregations is sparing the truth, that's speaking the word of Yahweh, the name of Yahweh Shad, that also gonna be showing mercy, okay? That worship the Lord in spirit and in truth, alright? So through the spirit, to those that have heard this word, I want to hit off with another scripture right here, Colossians chapter 2, verse 16, because you may very well have it to where you got those that are not celebrating the feast of Simon today, okay? Which ain't nothing wrong with that, man. I put it to you like this. I wasn't always aware that I was an Israelite. I wasn't always aware that I was a descendant of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. But through the grace and mercy of Yahweh and Yahweh Shah, for finding me in my madness when I was lost in the sauce in the world, having no hope, because I felt like I was alienated from what the commonwealth of what these scriptures were, through the spirit, I was given the grace and mercy to be able to understand the true wisdom, knowledge, and understanding. Who I learned from the apostles, elders, great millstone, and from other brothers, and being able to link up with brothers that are like-minded in these last days through the spirit of Yahweh in the name of Yahweh Shai. Okay? That may not be of the congregation of GMS, great millstone, but in sincerity and truth, then doing what Yahweh Shai said as far as being brotherly towards one another. Okay, loving one another, being charitable towards one another, and seeking out their soul salvation, treating others as they want to be treated through the spirit of Yahweh, namely Yahweh Shad. And you brothers and sisters that I've come in contact with and that I labor with, y'all know who y'all are, and may Yahweh in the name of Yahweh Shad bless y'all and y'all families, man, and y'all loved ones, man. You see, through the spirit, to those, I want y'all to understand that every single high holy day may not be something that you realize automatically, but you know what? The Lord knows your heart, okay? Like I said, I wasn't always celebrating these feasts, these high holy days, and I even put it to you like this, even in the faith, because normally attention only gets focused on the Passover, because that is a serious solemn assembly, a serious day when our forefathers were delivered out of Egypt. Okay, that day gets rehearsed. Even the Day of Atonement, when you gotta fast or afflict your soul, okay, don't eat, don't drink, okay, to atone for all the sins that you had did in the year, which even though Yahweh Shah is the atonement of our sins, you still have to rehearse the righteous acts. So you got days such as that. But through the Spirit, as far as the Feast of Simon, brothers may not get a chance to feast all the time. Sisters may not get a chance to feast in his society, feast in his captivity. But you know what? Being made aware of these things is beautiful and a blessing, because you know what? In the midst of us going through our affliction, going through our sentence, going through our prison term as far as being in this flesh and dealing what we got to deal with in society, we have this history to bring our hearts up, to bring our heads up, to bring our minds up, to let us know that there's a glorious reward coming. You see? There's a reward coming. And also, as a reminder, that these other nations ain't got nothing to do with the holy heavenly host, the holy laws, the commandments, the promises, the covenant, the blessings, okay, the kingdom of heaven. High holy days such as this, the Feast of Simon, show you that we fought against the other nations. It showed you that we rebelled from being wiped out as a nation. You see? And the thing about it is, you don't hear about these fake Jews, these gutter rats, so-called Jewish people, them Khazars, them Amalekites, them Edomites, them Jewish wishing that they were Jews. You don't hear about them celebrating things like the Feast of Simon. You may hear about Hanukkah, but you don't know exactly where they get that High Holy Day from. They get it from the Book of Maccabees. They took it from our High Holy Day customs. You may hear them speak about the Passover, but they don't tell you that the Passover pertains to our forefathers, not their forefathers. You see? You may not even hear about other High Holy Days such as the Feast of Nicanor, man, which you can hear about in the Book of Maccabees too, which the Lord had to where we celebrated from another deliverance from the heathens trying to bring us to slaughter, man. You see? This is something that you just got to keep in mind. And once again, so those that may not be able to celebrate this feast, or maybe celebrating it on a different day, or may this be your first time hearing this truth, you know what the scripture is for y'all, brothers and sisters. This is Colossians chapter 2, verse 16. Okay, the epistle of the Apostle Paul to those in Colossians chapter 2, verse 16. Let no man therefore judge you in meat or in drink, or in respect of a holy day, or in the new moon, or the Sabbath days, which are a shadow of things to come, but the body is of the anointed, whose word he calls Christ, his real name in Hebrew is Yahweh Shai. I'll read it again and slow it down for you, alright? Because I understand that, you know what, you may have brothers and sisters that just come into the faith that don't know about this feast, but you also may have brothers and sisters a part of different congregations that may not hold this feast. You know what? The Lord ain't gonna look at you no different, okay, if you're serving him and spreading the truth, if you don't hold this feast, okay? This is just something to be mindful of. Not every single congregation, not every single brother or sister in the faith knows about this feast, but through the spirit of the power of Yahweh, the name of Yahweh Shai, Yahweh Shai told Peter, if you love me, feed my sheep, feed my lamb, feed my flock. Okay, well, wasn't that your understanding? That's what I'm trying to do for you brothers and sisters. Make y'all aware of this great rich history that we have. But once again, if you may not be able to hold this feast, the Lord knows your heart, man. May Yahweh, name Yahweh Shai, also bless you, your families, have mercy upon you, your brothers, sisters, the wives of the prophets, the children of the prophets, the friends of the prophets, the righteous zealots, okay, to be able to at least have peace of mind in this captivity. Just like how our King, King David, okay, underneath our King of Kings, Lord of Lords, Yahweh Shai, spoke of in the Book of Psalms, the Lord maketh him to lie down in green pastures. He was being chased down by his adversaries, by the enemies, by the heathens, even by Saul. But you know what? The Lord still gave him peace to let it be known that he was dealing with it. That's why he said that his cup runneth over. So, once again, let no man therefore judge you in meat or in drink, or in respect of a holy day, or the new moon, or the Sabbath days. Okay? So, brothers and sisters that may not be able to hold this new moon or Sabbath day, or the exact same way that brothers in this congregation hold it, or in this church or in this camp hold it, or to brothers and sisters that may actually hold the Sabbath day on a Friday, Sunday, Saturday, Sunday, or not the new moon. You know what? In sincerity, the Lord hasn't blessed you to receive the full understanding of the new moon dictating the new month, the 7 days simultaneous after that is the Sabbath. Then that's between you brothers and sisters and the Lord. The thing about it is, I'm going to tell you like a brother and a sister told me, it's about, are you rehearsing righteous acts? Are you at least rehearsing the law? Are you at least trying to keep the Sabbath, you see? And not trying to point the finger at others saying who's wrong and who's right and who's going to get destroyed for not doing it the exact same way. Look, let no man therefore judge you in meat or in drink, whether a brother or sister may be a vegan, vegetarian, or may not be a vegan or vegetarian, but you all know we got to eat the lamb for the Passover, but nevertheless, let no one judge you or look at you weird for how you eat, okay? Or if you drink alcohol, if you don't drink alcohol, the Lord knows your heart. The scriptures speak about the Nazarites. Or in respect of a holy day, or the new moon, or the Sabbath days. You see exactly when you do it or when you hold it. Let no man judge you, therefore, or condemn you if you're going to make it the kingdom of heaven or not. You see, the scripture says, judge no man, lest he be judged. Okay, you pointing out what's going on with your brother. The mote that's in your brother's eye, you got to worry about your own soul salvation and the beam that's in your own eye. Don't be a hypocrite. These things are a shadow of things to come, because we can't keep the law, statutes, commandments perfectly, but we try to the best of our ability, because the body is of the anointed, Yahweh Shai HaMashiach, the deliverer, the intercessor, the big brother, okay? Our Lord and Savior. These are the things that we keep in mind. As in, when he comes back, he's coming back to set everything in order, set everything right for you, the kingdom to come, you see? The Lord is getting ready to do that. Lord willing, we're part of that. He's going to come back to bring balance in this world, man. Peace in this world. Salvation in this world. Okay? To the point of we ain't never going to have to worry ever again. Call Lord Yahweh in the name of Yahweh Shai. Praise be to Yahweh in the name of Yahweh Shai. And also with that in mind, what that entails, you other nations, okay? You heathens, you banker families, you Rothschilds, you Rockefellers, you Gettys, you Kissingers, you Blankfields, you Soros, you Kagans, you Sabins, okay, you Edomites, you Rothschilds, you so-called white people, men, you banker families, you Edomites, you descendants of Esau, you're going to get paid back. We're living in a time of feasting at the downfall of your forefathers. Your so-called New World Order back then didn't work, and it ain't going to work now. You understand that? It ain't going to work in these last days. You may try to get the whole world underneath your satanic subjection, but you know what? Even Satan himself is underneath the Heavenly Father. You see? He's even underneath the Lord. He's even underneath, okay, the King of Kings, Lord of Lords, Yahweh Shai, the Anointed. For you to understand. Yahweh. Okay? He's coming through to bring back deliverance through his son, Yahweh Shai, the Anointed. Not saying that this is what the Lord looks like, but just giving you a better understanding of a so-called black man with white woolly hair. Alright? White woolly hair. Burnished bronze skin. Coming back to win. Coming back to deliver his righteous women and men. Men and women. King of heaven. Alright? Through the spirit. Hey, hold on, y'all, by Shema Shah, man. I know there's a little rhymes in there, but even though I come with rhymes, I'm still on time. Okay? There ain't nothing wrong with rap. There ain't nothing wrong with hip-hop. There ain't nothing wrong with music. Just as long as it's in righteousness. Okay? And the Lord is pleased by it. Meaning, you're praising the Lord because this is the ultimate song. His wisdom, knowledge, and understanding. The gospel, the good news. So, I give all the thanks and honor and praise and glory unto you, Lord Father God, Yahweh in the name of Yahweh Shai, what is what we call Jehovah, and Yeshua, Jesus, God, Yahweh, and Yahweh Shai be the thanks, honor, and glory, okay, for putting the spirit on me to be able to do this video, to bring this edification on to you brothers and sisters, okay, may the Lord bless you, okay, bless the righteous of our people, the holy of our people, okay, the elect of our people, ultimately, man. As the scripture says, the tabernacle of David, King David, and his mighty men. Okay, may you be strengthened by this video. May the Lord bless you. Don't forget to pray. Don't forget to fast. Don't forget to humble yourselves. And don't forget to repent, okay? Repent, come back onto the Lord. It ain't too late, okay? It's never too late until the Lord finally shuts it down, you see? Don't let no man take your crown from you, okay? Sisters, don't let no one lead you astray. Okay, brothers, don't let no one be a stumbling block onto you. Work out your soul salvation with fear and trembling, and don't forget to be brotherly. Okay, we got a kingdom to come. We got a glorious, righteous kingdom to come with our King of Kings, Lord of Lords, Yahweh Shai, the Anointed, to deliver. Okay, so with that, Shalom, stay strong.